So a lot of you are baffled at the fast growth of some artists. I mean, it can be real depressing when you've been kind of playing with puddles and then some artist is all of a sudden going off like this gorilla. Well, there could be a lot of reasons your growth has stalled, but one of them I see far too often is the artists aren't making the connections between other artists that tell algorithms to connect and recommend you to the fans of those artists. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to make connections to other artists so algorithms start to recommend you on Spotify, TikTok, and Instagram, and other apps. Hi, I'm Jesse Cannon, a music marketing nerd who's teaching musicians how to grow their fan base from 0 to 10,000 fans, and this is Museformation. So let's get this out of the way. Some of you may be watching this video and wondering why this is important. If that's happening, I imagine it's due to you having missed my recent video on the biggest music marketing opportunity in music today, which is that features, collaborations, remixes, and split releases are the greatest music marketing opportunity ever in music, as they get you what I call artist page visibility, aka people see you on the artist page they already like and see your name next to a song they're enjoying, and when they're loving that song, they can have an easy hint to go deeper on you as you're already a part of a song they like and in the community with an artist they enjoy. And if you missed that video, I highly suggest you watch it after this is done. It'll be linked in the description and in the end screen since it's super important. But to get this more fully and why this is so important, this has a compounding effect. And for those of you who don't get what that means, it's the benefits of doing these collaborations is the effects are numerous and add up the more you do it as your audience grows. And if you recall from that other video, everyone I know at major labels and big indie labels is going in on this technique. And some of this is because artist page visibility and the labels seeing the power of an artist becoming a part of another artist community, but it also comes down to the compounding effects of what it does to algorithms. And I have news for you. One thing everyone who has big numbers will tell you, algorithms are usually driving the majority of that. Whether it's getting on the browse page of YouTube, Spotify Radio, Discover Weekly Recommendations, or recommendations on Instagram or TikTok serving up your video. I know some wise ass is going to ask for my sources for this video. If you simply look up the algorithms of any of these sites, there's articles on sites like The Verge, Techdirt, or the book Spotify Teardown. But most of all, I live in Brooklyn, where many of these startup employees live too, and boy do their lips get loose when we're out drinking. So go off in the comments if you must. But let's get into specifics. Let's first start with Spotify. So Spotify has one advantage that social media doesn't have, is that they have what are called music genomes, which are this thing Pandora invented where you can have computers analyze the sound of a song, and it can tell it's similar to another song in some ways. But while those help, the thing that Spotify weights in their algorithm is the connections you have to other artists. And those connections are largely for things like Spotify Radio, in that what gets recommended in Spotify Radio after an album gets done playing, or someone clicks the button on it, or they make a playlist with that artist, is being the artist that has a huge overlap with that artist and listeners. And this is easily observed, y'all. Next time your playlist or an album of an artist finishes, I bet within the next three artists, it'll be someone the artist has collabed with or toured with. And this is of course because doing those things together makes you have a combined audience with that other artist. Now of course, if the people they serve that song to continually click that button, you know, the one that says don't ever play this terrible song again, this one, well your song's not going to be recommended very much anymore. This is also what I see in my Discover Weekly playlist, is so much of the collabs that an artist has done before will get the other artist into my Discover Weekly playlist. But if you want to get on that coveted release radar, those collabs are the exact connective tissue that gets you on another artist Discover Weekly, as you're both going to get on each other's release radar, and then more people will inherently be listening to you both, showing the algorithm the common fandom, and you will now be in all the before mentioned algorithmic recommendations. This also goes for the YouTube algorithm, as YouTube gives no fucks about making any music genome, since they just observe user patterns and what people click or skip. But again, one of the many reasons these collabs, features, and split releases help so much for music marketing right now is listeners are less likely to skip you if 1. They recognize your voice or songwriting style, or 2. They've heard your name a bit, perhaps from collaborating or playing shows with another artist or being tagged on social media with their favorite artist, and they're familiar with your name enough to let the recommendation go. I find about half of the new songs I get into from what YouTube plays me after I listen to a song I like when I'm relaxing at night reading. But let's get into how this compounds with social media apps. Let's say you do a collab or a tour with another act. Instagram is looking at who at tag and follow. And when they see you following one artist, but not the most common at tags, that's how you get put in the discover recommendations, or when you click down to see who else you should follow on those little tabs on Instagram and TikTok. Literally, since Instagram only has user data of what people follow and click on to go off, that's what they base it off of. If you are of the top few mutual follows of an artist, that's when Instagram is cycling through when it does recommendations. And you know how you become one of the top follows? Is collabing or playing shows with that other artist. But the way this compounds is when people are tweeting and Instagramming and doing at tags about your collaboration or the shared show. That is not only telling Instagram to recommend users to see your name that are the most susceptible to liking you, but it's also the most adamant music fans are the ones who give you your early listens. Since they are such addicts for this genre, they see your name and listen to you, and you get that important new fan who's a tastemaker. And yet again, this is why I think Facebook ads are the dumbest thing to waste your money on, is it does none of this work and gives you the illusion of growth in numbers increasing, but they are unengaged fans with no influence on anyone else. Whereas the ad tags of fans seeing you play a show with someone or do a collab are the adamant ones who are going to tell other people about you on Reddit, Discords, and get the word of mouth recommendations, which are the most effective recommendations in music up to playlists and collabs. And I know a lot of you hate on Twitter and say you don't get it, but this is the type of promo that does great on Twitter, which is also every music journalist and playlist influencer's favorite app to be an addict on. And when they see your name intertwined with an artist, it's their literal job to go deeper and to do the thing they love the most in the world, which is to find a new artist before their other dork friends and brag about it for the entire duration of the artist fame that they were onto them before everyone else. But as insufferable as that is, these people can really help you get fans. So playing the game on Twitter and interacting with your community helps compound these algorithmic recommendations. But I know you are all very concerned with TikTok. And the same thing works here, in that you getting tagged with other artists gets people looking for you, but also TikTok can do so much work of linking yourself to other artists, since TikTok doesn't have any music genome either, and instead is spreading to people who engage with similar behavior patterns on the app. And those patterns are what hashtags and TikTok tropes they like to engage with, which is knowing why your community's TikTok hashtags and Instagram ones are so important for linking together. Doing those hashtags will put your content in front of the people of the eyes who like that hashtag and who interact with that hashtag the most. In other words, in front of the eyes and ears of people most susceptible to liking you. At tagging the artists you collab with teaches them to link you two together. So in doing collabs, having multiple TikToks about your collab, whether it's footage of you working together from the music video or whatever, you may not get the most viral numbers, but the algorithm starts to know the work to do for spreading you around. Making videos where you do that thing where you say, if you like this artist, you'll like me every few months, and tagging them can help do this work too by bringing you into the algorithm of those bigger artists. Now remember, the smaller you go, the more chance of it doing that, since the algorithm has thousands of other artists doing that for the big artists. TikTok does have one more element of stitching you to other users and sending content to users. The songs in your background of your videos are like hashtags, in that they regularly serve people who use the same song to make videos to users who watch the video with that song. So bearing this in mind with the combination of a hashtag, this can help you get you in front of the fans of your micro genre. So to tie this all together, now that you get this ecosystem, even if you aren't making songs with these other artists, you've hopefully done your community work and are making artist playlists and music talk shows and tagging the artists on it on Twitter, TikTok, and Insta, and yet again, drawing more connections to you and the artists similar to you. In time, if you keep doing this, you'll have so many connections to you and such a big community, you will be algorithmically favored and connected to so many artists. So you really are going to have some terrible songs for it to not work out. Come back here and thank me later, or maybe just share this video with a friend now in advance.